Blood cultures. Routine blood cultures are indicated on any patient in whom there is a suspicion of bacteremia or candidemia. Surveillance for infection before the clinical suspicion of infection is not an indication for blood culture. Timing and recommended procedure. Blood for culture should be drawn prior to the institution of antibiotics whenever possible. If empiric treatment is an emergency, blood for culture should still be drawn as soon as possible after institution of antibiotics. Acute febrile episode. 2 sets from separate sites, all within 10 minutes, before the start of antimicrobials. Non-acute disease. Antimicrobials should not be started or changed immediately. 2 or 3 sets from separate sites, all within 24-hour intervals, no closer than 3 hours. Acute endocarditis. 3 sets from 3 separate sites within 1 to 2 hours before antimicrobials, if possible. Pyrexia of unknown origin. 2 or 3 sets from separate sites more than 1 hour apart during a 24-hour period. If negative, at 24 to 48 hours, obtain 2 or 3 more sets. Site of blood culture. Blood should be obtained from peripheral venous sites. Specimen collection. Refer to the phlebotomy section for correct sample collection techniques. Dispensing of blood into culture bottles. Inspect the culture media bottles prior to inoculation. Do not use a bottle of culture medium if it shows signs of contamination, that is, the broth appears turbid. Wipe the top of the bottle using an ethanol ether swab. Using a sterile syringe and needle, withdraw about 20 milliliters of blood from an adult or about 5 milliliters from a young child. Insert the needle through the rubber liner of the bottle cap and dispense 10 to 15 milliliters of blood into the diphasic culture medium bottle containing 25 milliliters of broth. When also culturing for anaerobes, dispense about 5 milliliters of blood into the thioglycolate culture medium containing 50 milliliters of broth. Using a fresh ethanol ether swab, wipe the top of each culture bottle. Mix the blood with the broth and do not allow it to clot, as any bacteria, if present, will become trapped in the clot. Label each bottle with the name and number of the patient and the date and time of collection. As soon as possible, incubate the inoculated media. Number of blood cultures. Because microorganisms might be present in the blood continuously in some diseases and intermittently in others, to increase the chances of isolating a pathogen, it is usually recommended that at least 2 to 3 specimens of blood collected at different times should be cultured. The blood specimens collected should be spaced an hour apart from separate venipuncture sites using separate needles and syringes. It should be immediately dispensed into a sterile blood culture medium bottle, which can be obtained from the microbiology laboratory. The blood should be transported immediately to the laboratory, where it can be placed in the incubator or an automated blood culture instrument. Blood culture media. Basic blood culture medium is usually a liquid medium containing a nutrient broth and an anticoagulant. Columbia broth, tryptocase soy broth, brain heart infusion broth, supplemented peptone, or thioglycolate broth are some of the liquid media available commercially. Diphasic blood culture medium. A diphasic or castaneda blood culture medium is one that combines an agar slope with a broth medium. The blood broth is allowed to run over the agar slope at regular intervals by tipping the bottle. Microbial growth can be indicated by colonies appearing on the slope beginning at the broth-agar interface. The advantage of this method is that it avoids the need of subculture, hence reducing the risk of contamination. Diphasic medium should be incubated at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade for up to 7 days. A longer incubation period should be allowed when endocarditis is suspected. Thioglycolate broth needs to be incubated at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade for up to 2 weeks. Examination for growth and subculture. For diphasic or broth medium, use a hand lens to examine twice daily for microbial growth up to 7 days or 4 weeks when brucellosis is suspected. Microbial growth is indicated by colonies growing on the agar slope, usually beginning at the agar-broth interface. For thioglycolate broth culture, examine daily for up to 14 days for visible signs of bacterial growth. When there are signs of bacterial growth, subculture the broth. Subculturing a blood culture broth. A strict aseptic technique must be used to avoid contaminating the culture. Clean the top of the bottle using an ethanol ether swab. Using a sterile needle and small syringe, insert the needle through the rubber liner in the cap and withdraw about 1 milliliter of the broth culture. Inoculate the broth on blood agar, chocolate agar, McConkie agar, and use the streak plate method. Incubate the blood agar plate anaerobically for up to 48 hours, the chocolate agar plate in a carbon dioxide atmosphere for up to 48 hours, and the McConkie agar plate aerobically overnight. Swab the top of the culture bottle and re-incubate. Contamination of blood cultures. Contamination can occur when an aseptic technique is not used at the time of blood collection or at a later stage while subculturing. Frequent contaminants of blood cultures include commensal staphylococci, micrococci, and diphtheroids, or contaminants from the environment such as species of bacillus or acinetobacter. Contamination is indicated when an organism is recovered from only one bottle and not in the others, or when a mixed microbial flora is isolated.